It's December in the winter land of Kosovo, and all the residents are living happily. This is a little town in which everything stays perfect, with a garden bear peacefully watching over the land.
The 10 key cards must stay in order at the foot of the village. In the last century, nothing dire has happened in the town until one day, two residents walk by and...
It's such a beautiful day, I'm sure nothing can ruin it.
The snow's falling on the ground, and Christmas cheer is in the air.
No, the cards are deported. I think the only way to solve this problem is to use a sorting algorithm. I think the best choice is research.
Of course not. My favorite sorting algorithm is dual pivot Quicksort. I think we should use that.
Maybe we should learn a little bit of more of them first, and then decide.
Set the first and last elements in the array as the pivots, switch them if the left one is larger than the right. The eye indicates which element is being partitioned in this step, but it could be either smaller than left pivot, equal or greater than left pivot, and equal or smaller than the right pivot, or greater than the right pivot. Here you can see all the cards in the first array are being sorted. There are now three groups or sub-arrays. The dual Quicksort algorithm is recursively called again to sort the elements in the sub-array. The function is called once again for the final unsorted sub-array. All the elements are sorted and they're put back into the original array.
Dividing it in half. Now you want to divide these subarrays into more subarrays. Now you want to make each element an individual element. Now that we have divided, now we must conquer. I will use I and J as reference. So As you can see, I must be less than J. If not, switch. So in this case, 7 is greater than 2. So we must switch and merge. Now, same thing. Okay, now this time, we're going to compare the first element of each array. I equals to 2 and J equals to 3. 2 is in fact less than 3, therefore we merge. Now, same thing. I equals to 7, J equals to 9. I is less than J, therefore we merge. Now we have a new subarray. Same thing. Now I equals to ace, which equals to 1, and J equals 5. So I is in fact less than J, therefore we merge. Now we must check, now we must resort this portion. So I equals 5, J equals 4. Since I is greater than J, we must switch. Now I equals to 5 and J equals to 6. Now since I is less than J, we must merge. Now that this subarray is fully sorted, we can begin merging. Take the first element of each array. J is less than I, therefore we create a new array. Now, moving on. I is equal to 9 and J equals to 10. Wait, I less than J, so we merge I. And J gets merged because it's the last element.
Back to watching over our town. Now we can go back.